Okay, I want to do a little video here on my Thompson Center Greyhawk again. I did a video on this thing, like, I don't know, it's quite a while ago. And then I did a video recently that I had actually had fired the thing with patch round ball, and it, like, shot, like, terrible at, like, 50 yards. So I was always kind of didn't really like that counterboard kind of muzzle thing that they had on these. That's I don't know what the hell they call it. Anyway, it's some sort of a, like a counterboard thing, so it made it easier to load like sabots and stuff like that. But it was, there was like that, and then there was like a little bit behind it was sort of pitted, like this gun sort of, like, I don't know, like it's sort of a mix master, like it's got like a New Englander lock on it and a Greyhawk barrel, and I think the stock is actually off like a the New Englander synthetic or anyway. So after it shooting that poorly, I which wasn't really that definitive of a test anyway. Figured it's like hell with it. Just cut that crap off. Like if you go on the forums, that's sort of common. Like I think Thompson Center kind of like started putting that on their muzzleloaders like right at the end before they got bought out. So a lot of people didn't really like it and they thought that it wasn't great because I don't know, sometimes it wasn't bored. The counterbore wasn't in line with the rest of the barrel or something, which I've read, which I don't know if that's true. It looked like it was fairly well done, but anyway, I don't need it because I'm not gonna. I wasn't really planning on shooting sabots anyway, and all this kind of stuff. So I was like, whatever, just chop that crap up so you can see how much. If you watch the old video, the barrel was out. Anyway, it's like an inch or whatever is hacked off. Get rid of that. Plus, I think a tiny bit of the barrel, like the first part of the barrel, was a little bit of pitting and stuff. Put a new dovetail. Put the old sight back on. Put a new back sight, which is sort of like the sights that are on the, I don't know, Traditions or Spanish muzzleloaders. It's got elevation and windage and stuff, but they're not as good as the Thompson Center equivalent. But the sight that was on it, like there was a Williams or whatever. Was it Firesight or whatever that one that was on it? And it was crappy because it was like aluminum and it got chewed up or something, so it didn't work. So then we changed it to like a 22 kind of sight on it, and that didn't really work out because it had movement and stuff anyway. So that's what we got. We're gonna work with. Take it out and try it anyway. But anyway, so I'm sort of ready for the next rainstorm at the Blue Mountain Club anyway, so if it's forecasting rain, I think I'll take this if I get it sighted in anyway. And it's 50 caliber, 1/48 twist, so I plan on shooting round ball out of it. Try to sight it in with that, but I might try to sight it in with conicals, like the Lyman Maxi or the Lee Real Slug or something, which I've ever had luck with those. Like I don't know, like they're cheap and everything. Like they seem like they shoot okay at close range, but you start going 50 yards, they start shooting all over the place. So I don't know, but I might try them because I do have the, was it 320 grain or whatever, 50 caliber real bullet. So, but I think I'd rather get the Lyman Maxi Slug or whatever, which is, well, the Lyman one's basically a copy of the Thompson Center Maxi bullet or whatever. But so it's a, they're really nice gun overall. Like they're, stainless, so they're fairly low maintenance, plastic stock, and all this kind of stuff. So anyway, this will update on that gun anyway, so we'll probably do a little bit something this winter or whatever, or next little while, shooting it and see if I can get it sort of figured out or if it's a total write-off. So, anyway, talk to you later.